degree number 5 for me. I'm psychotic. I love learning. But in addition to teaching in the academic arena, I've done most of my teaching in the corporate arena. So I'm what you refer to as a corporate trainer. In addition to doing corporate training, I've also managed five different corporate training centers. And I've had my own business for 4 years, and I will admit to this group. Okay. So, but this is my the chair of my dissertation committee and my advisor and a good friend at this point, Diane Chapman, and she helped me out with this whole study, which has been absolutely fascinating. So I basically took a look at probably the most problematic thought that I had all these years working in the corporate training arena. The biggest problem that I had is I knew that as a corporate trainer and as somebody managing corporate trainers, the best way to earn money for my, we're not academia, we don't get federal funds or state funds, so we only get what the students bring us, the corporate participants. And the best way to get that money in is to know that I have a great trainer in the room. They're the front line. So if I have a really good trainer in the front, they tell really good stories and they're really riveting, people are going to go, wow, I want more classes with that person, and they're going to come back. Just like we all have favorite college professors, right? Say it. He's like me. Yeah, okay. I see how this goes. But so I was wondering, what makes that person? Because I've hired other professors and other college academians in to teach corporate classes, and they've fallen flat on their faces. I've hired in people who said they could do corporate people, and they've fallen flat on their faces. I'll hire somebody that I'm not real sure about, and they will be like, you know, I don't know, Oprah at the front of the classroom, right? All right. So I wanted to know what in the world were the viewpoints of the participants coming to class that made them want to come back and take a class with the same corporate trainer over and over again. That was my main premise there. So here's the research questions. What were the viewpoints of corporate trainer characteristics that trainees say influenced their decision to seek out the same corporate trainer for additional training? So I didn't want to know if they didn't like the person, and I didn't want to know if they didn't like the person well enough to go back to them again. I wanted to know what caused them to say, I want more with that one person. Those were the people I wanted working for my training company. And of course, I wanted to look at what was similar across all viewpoints and what was different. Same thing. So this is how corporate training works. Basically, the participant takes an external training course, and we all know now, everybody understands that continuing professional education is just, it's what you do, whether you're in the academic arena or the corporate arena. So they're going to take a class, and then basically they are going to decide for themselves if they ever want to come back and take another class with this person. If they decide they do, then the participant has gotten a lot of training experience. They're probably going to be able to do their job better. They're probably going to talk about the class. Oh my gosh, I took a class with George. He was super fantastic. You need to go take a class with him. They're probably going to take more courses with us. That is going to, in turn, make us more profitable as a training center, and that's the number one goal. We also want to have a reputation for quality instruction because that's going to bring more people into us and, again, increase that bottom line. And the training center will then have a better return on investment, which will just help the whole thing propel and continue on. If they do not have a good experience, if they do not feel connected to the instructor, then nobody wins, right? They're not happy, the training center's not happy, the instructor's not happy. So I wanted to find out what would cause all of this other great stuff to occur. All right, you guys know all this stuff, so I'm going to just kind of bypass it. I will not have you notice the numbers. My QSET was, I'll start out with this. My concourse, I did an extensive lit review. There was basically nothing on corporate training. So I went and looked for, what are the qualities of a popular college professor? Or what are the qualities of a popular high school professor? Those were the items that I looked for. And all the different derivations of that. And I ended up with over 200 statements, which I then boiled down with the help of this lovely woman up here to 57. And then I ended up with 55 participants. Now, my participants were people that took classes. I just recently left my position. I was running the corporate training division at North Carolina State University in Raleigh, North Carolina. And so I looked for people who had taken classes with us, who had taken at least two classes with at least two different instructors, so they have an idea of what corporate trainers were like, and they have an idea of who they liked and who they didn't like. So those were my qualifiers. So I ended up with 55 people that could do that. And then I used HTMLQ. Have any of you used that? HTMLQ? Good, don't. All right. It's old and it's very challenging. All right. So I ended up with 55 respondents, educational levels were off the charts. They were smart people. They were people that had good jobs and companies that were large enough that they were willing to spend money on the training that these people might need to have. And if you'll notice, most of these people had a higher income because, again, these are hardworking people. These are people that have professional jobs. The age is right where you think it would be for people in big companies. And then the ethnicity, that was really interesting because that ethnicity is not representative of our area, but for corporate training, it probably is. So that's problematic as well. So these were the numbers that I came up with. I'm not going to bore you with all of them. Just know that I looked at 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7 factors. And you'll notice if you look at the 7 factor group, there was one group that had no participants. And for that reason alone, I went with 6 factors. Okay, everything else was fairly close. So these were the factor characteristics for the 6 factor solution that I selected. And everything by the book just goes along with the way that it should in a Q study. So that was great. And this is what I got. So these are the demographics for the 6 factor group that I selected. Again, a few more females than males. Very high educational levels, high income, older people, and predominantly Caucasian. And this was a breakdown, these were the groups that I came up with. So I had, if you look at it, 16 of my people ended up wanting to be entertained and involved. It's interesting, when corporate people come to class, and I think this is why people have trouble teaching them, nobody calls roll. Nobody gives assignments, nobody gives grades. Are y'all with me on this? And you've got usually 6 to 8 hours to make people really super like you. So these people have to almost be entertainers, and that's what corporate people expect. They expect to walk in and have the class go just like this, full of everything that they want to see, and they want to have fun while they're doing it. So that's the entertaining and involving group. We then had a group that they were like, I don't really need to be entertained, but I have to know this before I go back to the office tomorrow. So they were super serious about training. They were really deadly serious about what they wanted to get out of the training day. The third one is kind of a hybrid of the first two. So looking for a well-rounded trainer, they wanted to be entertained, but they were also extremely serious about what they had to take back to the office with them. The fourth one, and I thought this was interesting in our day of kind of an uneasy climate. When I started going through school, which was before most of you in here, we never had to worry about safety in the school. And now, because of Columbine and things like that, we're all concerned about safety in school. It doesn't matter which school it is. Well, these people wanted a safe learning environment, but it wasn't the physical safety that they were worried about. When corporate individuals come to class, they want to know that they're going to be respected, that if they ask questions, they're not going to be seen as stupid, that they want to be able to bring up opinions and ideas that might not be the norm. So they wanted a safe environment from a, you know, I want to feel like I can come in and just be myself and learn in this environment. That was the safety that they were referring to there. Be a teacher friend. A lot of corporate people want to be friends with the instructor, just like they do in college. They want to be friends with the professor. So it was another group. And then the last one, they were there just to be motivated. They wanted to feel like they had, had a fire lit under them so that they could go back to the office and do the stuff they needed to do. So those are my 6 groups. To kind of flesh it out a little bit more, the best quote for the entertainment and involving group says, I am most involved and learn more when the instructor delivers a dynamic classroom presentation. So they wanted to be included. They wanted to be asked for their opinions. They wanted to be asked if they had any additional experience that they could give to the day. So you'll notice my defining statements over here tonight. Dynamic classroom presentations, effective communication, encourages questions, discussions, interactions, the sharing of knowledge, displays energy, enthusiasm, passion, encourages participant interaction, and gives feedback to participants. If you think about it, you've got a favorite teacher in your mind, they kind of do all that stuff anyway. Doesn't matter if they're a corporate instructor or a college professor or high school. The Serious About Training group, here's their quote. I don't want to waste my time in class with an unprepared instructor. So these people are hardcore. They want the instructor to come to class prepared, to communicate effectively. They want the instructor to know the subject thoroughly, to use real-world examples. They want them knowledgeable. They want them to project credibility, and they want to have extensive practical experience in their field. They should not be overly enthusiastic or fake, this is so specific, but should rather teach with an attitude that displays a level of passion for the topic being taught. Like laughter and smiles, good energy is contagious. That was this group. So teach me, but make it really palatable and kind of, you know, good to be there. So they want the instructor to know their subject thoroughly, project credibility, display energy, enthusiasm, and passion, encourages questions, blah, blah, blah. No expert in their field. Has extensive practical experience and has fun in the classroom. So that's the hybrid group. Create a safe learning environment. Like I said, it didn't have anything to do with the physicality of the safety, but rather being accepted. So a safe environment is important so that students feel open to share. So it was, you know, being able to ask those questions or make those comments without somebody going, what are you saying, right? All right, so facilitates mutual respect with participants, creates a safe environment in the classroom, willing to entertain different ideas, encourages questions, discussions, interaction, and sharing of knowledge. That's this group. Next group, be a teacher friend. Relationships are key to everything. That was the quote I got from those folks. Defining statements, has fun in the classroom, cares what students think of them, comes to class prepared, and displays sound teaching methodology. We have the motivating group, which is the last group. Here's the quote. It is important for the instructor to encourage you on challenging aspects of the course. We want them to come to class prepared, deliver dynamic classroom presentations, and make participants feel empowered to learn. So give them that spark so that they go back to the office ready to rock and roll. So these were the items that were similar across all participants in viewpoints. Statement does not try to control interactions in the classroom. 100% of the people wanted the instructor to control the interactions in the classroom. They didn't want anybody to get out of control. They want the instructor to make the environment feel safe and to be the one in charge. And then comes to class prepared was ranked really high as well. Almost everybody wanted that. We have three groups there. And then the ones that were ranked really low has high level academic degrees in their field. Sorry to say, but business people don't care. They want you to be an expert in what you're doing. So whether you have a PhD or not, if you can explain something, they're going to go with you. Has a no-nonsense demeanor in the classroom is another one that's ranked really low. And then finally, share stories about the personal life. They don't care. Mm-hmm. Items that were different across all participants and viewpoints right here. We've got several different statements for each one. But just notice the third one, the hybrid group, there's nothing there. So we had some really interesting findings here. Limitations, this was done on corporate training, and it was done on one particular group. Not all universities have a corporate training division, so that made it really unique as well. And so taking the same type of study and spreading it across a lot of other arenas would, I'm sure, make it a lot more meaningful and fun. So we'd love to basically take this information and share it. I already started doing that. With people like myself, people who've managed corporate training facilities, also with corporate trainers who want to become better at what they do, to know what people are expecting of them.
So lots of implications. And hopefully we'll have some further studies or some recommendations. It'd be fun to look at private corporate training entities instead of ones done through universities, studied in different states, countries, and even continents like this one. Study on external corporate training perspectives, on external training center manager viewpoints, lots of different opportunities here.
Case study is fun. I think that's why we're all here. Mm-hmm. It's a really interesting way to find things out. And so I think there, especially in the world of corporate training, which we haven't done a lot in that area yet, there are a lot of possibilities, just a lot.
I told you all I use HTMLQ. I'm
also a technology person. I'm a geek. And so I knew that a lot of my people, especially busy corporate people, they don't have a lot of time. They didn't want to come in and, you know, it'd be hard to get them in and have them do the sort. And so I basically used HTMLQ, which was created by MIT. once they signed the DocuSign, they thought they were done a lot of them. So, like, they literally never launched the study, and I'd have to send out their emails.